the next, which is related to the membership, the wide membership of the ESA, because this is also what we'd like you, in a way, to sign up to, as the Bureau suggests. The rights, benefits, and obligations of members is that we expect an active participation in the exchange, networking, and knowledge sharing platforms that the ESA provides. Only if we all participate in that process of member-to-member exchange, again, can we fully benefit of the wonderful opportunities of learning from each other that our association offers.
I wish to invite the Secretary General to present the report of activities for 2008-2010.
This has been a period of considerable change in our association, and this change has taken place under the headline of a new ESA. 2008-2010 is a major step and a longer-term strategy to strengthen the value of the ESA for its members. Secondly, major achievements during the period that support the four key strategic objectives of the ESA will be presented. And at the end, I will present you a set of conclusions as regards the triennium. I will also talk about where we are as regards building the new ESA and where we are in terms of the coming triennium. I have the pleasure to show you the next slide, which is a slide which is only a few days old, because the ESA has achieved a certification of its management system according to the ISO 9001:2008 standard.
The driving force of any profession includes not only the special knowledge, skills and standards that it demands, but the duty to serve responsibly, selflessly and wisely, and to establish an inherently ethical relationship between professionals and society. The best defense is to have a group of individuals who are determined to do right. I'm convinced that we are that group, and that we are in the best position to serve, defend, and protect the mandates of our institutions. Thank you very much for the opportunity to speak here.
It is practical, it is comprehensive, it's relevant. It's dynamic. It's a work in progress. Submit your comments for its improvement.
It was your commitment and dedication which enabled us to finish this unique research project, which provides a truly global perspective on high performance in Social Security Administration.
The findings of the survey support the fact that high performing Social Security agencies today put families first, they focus unfailingly on innovation, and they are not limited by geography or by their status as a developed or developing country.
I'll be talking about position as an active contributor to society from the perspective of the National Provident Fund in Samoa, a country that's labeled or classified as the least developed country, soon to be a developing country, so that you can understand my perspective when I'll be talking about this subject.
Having done research in a number of other policy fields, is that it seems like that the mutual learning in social security seems to be very high.
What brings me to the ISA good governance guidelines for institutions with external fund managers, and in particular to the alignment of incentives.
Firstly, actuarial soundness. Second, enforcing the prudent person principle in investment management. Thirdly, prevention and control of fraud and corruption in contributions and benefits. Fourth, service standards for members and beneficiaries. Fifth, staffing policies and performance appraisals. And sixth, investments in ICT infrastructure.
That's really what I see actuarial valuations as being all about. It's not a calculation, it's not a 40-page document, it's not even pretty graphs or a discussion with your management board. It's about a wider process of engagement, about steering your organization as part of its financial sustainability in the long term.
Important to think carefully about why we do this and what should come from an operation like this. If we enter into measures such as poverty rates or take-up rates or the success of the policies put in place, I think we're basically going down the wrong route.
Ça renvoie à la capacité à bien préciser le profil de l'organisation et à faire des comparaisons qui soient tenables, qui veuillent dire quelque chose. Parce que effectivement, quand vous avez une organisation qui gère le risque vieillesse, il n'est pas neutre de savoir que cette organisation gère aussi la collecte des cotisations qui vont avec ou ne gère pas cette collecte. Merci.